the degeneracy that is TikTok, or even just the internet in general, you will find a disturbing trend, specifically among the young women of today. You will see stories and small clipped videos of women saying that there are no need for men anymore, that men are obsolete. Of course, you have that that video of Cher being asked if you know she thinks men are important. She says, "What for?" Of course, that was slightly taken out of context, right? There are reports that, you know, she was trying to be more specific as, and, you know, does she need a man for what? For love, for companionship, for what does she need a man for specifically? But again, that overall, the message still remains. Many people growing up today are taught that there are strong, independent women who don't need no men, and that men are obsolete. And that flies right in the face of godly masculinity and the roles that God gave men to play. Today, throughout our video, we're going to discuss what it means to bring societal stability as men. You're listening to the Resilient Masculinity Podcast. Thank you for tuning in. My name is William. I'm your host, as always. Thank you once again for joining us. Today we are talking about societal stability, how as men we bring safety, stability, and service. And today is no different. We're going to discuss societal stability, how men bring stability to society, to their communities, and their areas. I just want to start out with some statistics. These are from 2019 from the U.S. Department of Health. 63%, or sorry, this is fatherlessness in statistics, okay? So these are stats coming from all across the United States. In 2019, fatherless households showed, or if you were in a fatherless home, or those who had fatherless households, 63% of youth suicides had no father in the household. 90% of all homeless and runaway children had no fathers in the household. 90%, 9 out of 10 of homeless and runaway children had no father in the household. 85% of all children who showed behavioral disorders had no fathers in the household. 80% of rapists with anger problems, which, one, I think that's just interesting. 80% not only of rapists, but specifically those with anger problems, had no fathers in the household. 71% of all high school dropouts had no fathers. 75% of adolescent patients in chemical abuse centers, so those who abuse drugs and chemicals, 75% of the teens in there and the adolescents, the young adults, had no fathers in the households. 85% of youth in prison had no fathers in the household. 71% of pregnant teenagers had no fathers in the household. And 63%, again, of youth suicides had no fathers in the household. Just from those stats alone, you can see that when a man is involved in his household, and he's a good man, and he's a strong man, and he's a masculine man, and he's a godly man, you can see how these stats obviously could change. You can see how we need fathers who are engaged with their family. And it's not just 1%, it's not just one child, it's not just one teen pregnancy, but it's when that happens on a grand scale, you see society change. I've talked about it the last several episodes. We saw in 2020, we saw mass violence. We saw mass riots and looting and pillaging and plundering. What for? Because people were angry, people were upset, and so they thought the best way that they could demonstrate that anger and that frustration was to enact violence on innocent people. Fathers did not teach their children to have good anger management. They did not teach their children how to respectfully deal with politics. They did not teach their children how to be good moral people in this world. Instead, they, in their absence, they learned violence incorrectly handled. Non-tamed, not bridled anger. Meekness is the idea of strength under power, like a horse with all this energy under a bridle, right? So you've got this horse, and it can trample people, it could kill people. But it's under control, it's got a bridle on, it's being controlled by someone. It's being controlled, self-controlled. Just as that, right? There's good violence, right? We enact good violence against those who would hurt the innocent. We enact righteous violence against those who would harm innocent people. But that violence can just as easily become evil and wicked and depraved when you use that violence to then hurt other innocent people. So, we need men today. We need men who are strong, who are capable of violence, right? I'm a police officer. My job is to protect people. If there's an active shooter, I go towards the threat and I make sure that I stop that threat. Just like you saw in that Nashville Covenant school shooting, the Christian school shooting. Just as we saw there, you go straight to the threat. You don't help the innocent who are bleeding because you have to stop the killing first. Okay, just as anyone else, and I'd do that regardless of if I was a police officer or not. You have the moral responsibility, men, as protectors, you have the moral responsibility. If there's an active shooter, you get your family out of there and you make sure that the threat neutralizes it. Men, this is what we do. We protect, we provide, we lead. Society would crumble without us. 99% of all infrastructure jobs, between road work and sewer and power line and energy substations and subway construction and construction and civil engineering, like all those blue collar jobs, they're majority held male jobs. Why? Because we as men know without these things, society will crumble. Without energy, this society would crumble. Without men and women to protect the innocent, we would see society crumble into anarchy. Without strong men who are willing to take up the shield and the sword, we will have no one to protect us from our enemies. We've known that for generations. We've known that for hundreds of years. And it's in modernity, it's in this modern age when so everything's so easy and automated and artificial that we forget that. There's no toxic masculinity in Ukraine. As soon as war broke out in Ukraine, you want to know what happened? The women and children fled and the men stayed behind to fight. There's no such thing as toxic masculinity in Ukraine. Because that's how God created this world. That's how God created the system. And men, it is your job to bring that stability to your community. What does that look like? Again, I mentioned just a minute ago, jobs. Oftentimes our jobs bring us, our vocations bring us into play with bringing some sort of stability to those around us. Because what are jobs? What is work? It's fulfilling the needs of others. Meeting the needs of others. So whether you're an energy substation worker, great, you're providing energy to your community. You're a police officer, you're protecting your community from those who would do them harm. You're a member of the United States military or your country's military, great, you protect them from foreign invaders and again those who would do them harm. build construction. Guess what? You're building, literally, you're building the future. Blue-collar jobs all the time, men. We're often thrown into that. Those are often the trades that we go into willingly. And ultimately, they generally provide some kind of service and stability for those around us. And oftentimes, it's a thankless job. So as a man, you have to be ready to not be thanked. And that's okay. We see you. We hold you up. We raise a beer or a Mountain Dew or whatever you have. You know, and we say, thank you. Let's get back to work, right? So, oftentimes it's our vocation. Other ways, men, be involved in your local politics. Know what's going on. Be part of your neighborhood, community, you know, associations if you have any. Go to city council meetings. Learn what your city is doing. Learn what your county is doing. Be involved. In June of this year, our city, Midwest City, Oklahoma, declared June of 2023 to be Pride Month. And there was one person in that entire room full of people who didn't stand up and applaud that, and that was me. Because I know I don't support that degeneracy. And I know this episode automatically is just going to get me canceled right there, but guess what? I don't support that. And I was not going to let that happen. And I wrote then my council member about how, you know, the stats on LGBTQ, how it's degeneracy, how it promotes sexual deviancy and perversion. And men, you have to be willing to make a stand. You have to be willing to at least be the one person. Right? If you're the one person, maybe nothing's going to happen, but maybe something will. And maybe someone else saw that and was encouraged by that and did the same. Like I said, I can't change the world, but I can make a stand here. This is my city, and this city is going to one day, maybe not in my lifetime, maybe not in five lifetimes, but in six generations, this city will bend the knee to Christ. Where we have Christian council members and Christian schools and Christian businesses because Christians love and serve their neighbors. And men, we love and serve our neighbors. So build businesses that serve your community. Be a good employer to your community. Provide well for those around you. Your family can be involved in the local sphere as well, right? Like, my wife bakes, and she's baked cakes before, and we're no big business, but she's done a few commissioned cakes for people, and word has gotten out, and she's gotten a few more before, and that has done really well and serves a need in our community. Right, I often ask on our Facebook pages, what kind of local businesses do our areas need, our city need, our communities need? What kind of businesses would be helpful to those in our communities? Now, I'm not in a place right now financially to be able to do so, but Lord willing, one day I will build more businesses. So I can serve my society and my community. That's ultimately what we do as men, right? We serve our community, we love them, we bring stability by raising our children not to become another statistic. If your child is part of the riots, you bring them home and you put the fear of God back in them, right? You nurture your kids in the admonition and the nurture of Christ. You build and raise godly men and women. Your kids won't be a statistic. Your family's legacy will not be brought down to another statistic. You will raise your children well. You will teach them how to be good Christian men and women. You will set the example. You and your wife will be an example to those around you. You'll be a pillar in your church, and you'll be involved in local civic sphere, and that's how you bring stability to your society. Because ultimately it's an outflow of your family, right? We read last week the quote from Pope John Paul II, right? As goes the family, goes the nation, and as goes the nation, goes the whole world in which we live in, right? But it starts with the family. It starts with you as the head of the family. You set that tone. That's what we said last week. You set that tone. So be involved in local civic sphere. Be a businessman. Be a politician. Not a politician. Be a statesman. Care about those in your area. Don't become a career politician. Become a true statesman. Be involved. Care about your people. Care about your community. If you're a business owner, create businesses that serve the needs of those around you. We'll discuss that more in depth later on. If you're another blue-collar employee like me, then you do your job to the best of your ability. You serve those through business. Again, we'll talk about that later. Know that God is using you every day. It may not seem like a lot, especially with the 24-hour news cycle. I know it's hard. Trust God. Trust the process. Continue to work. Continue to disciple your family. Continue to be men. That's all I have to say this week. I will see you next time. Again, gentlemen, take action and become the men you are called to be. Till next time.